Story at 5, a stunning decision in a high-profile murder case. A Baltimore judge today ordered a new trial for the man convicted of killing 16-year-old Phylicia Barnes.
Yeah, the decision came just 6 weeks after Michael Johnson was found guilty of murder. 11 News I-Team lead investigative reporter Jane Miller is live tonight at Courthouse East. And Jane, what happened?
Well, Stan, there was an audible gasp in the packed courtroom when Judge Alfred Nance announced his decision just after lunch, or just after 12 o'clock. This afternoon after hearing arguments all morning. It is something that almost never happens, but it did today, dealing prosecutors a huge blow in a high-profile case. The father of Phylicia Barnes left court today clearly disappointed.
Let's do it again. The state reassured me that we're going to retry Michael Maurice Johnson for murdering Phylicia. It's a setback, but my spirit is still great. My family's spirit is still great, so we're going to keep it moving.
Baltimore Judge Alfred Nance ruled Michael Johnson deserves a new trial because he found the prosecutors withheld critical information about the state's key witness in the Phylicia Barnes murder case, inmate James McCray.
I think it was pretty obvious that the state got caught with their hand in the cookie jar.
McCray testified Johnson called him the day Phylicia died, showed him her body, and said he killed her to keep her quiet after having sex. He was the only witness to so directly pin Johnson with the crime. But the judge agreed with Johnson's lawyers that prosecutors failed to disclose the full story about McCray's criminal record. They turned over a handwritten summary of his record, not the typical rap sheet, including the fact McCray had been in custody in Baltimore County. That's important because it may have allowed McCray to know key details about the crime through the media. Prosecutors told jurors there's no way he would have had access.
When you do the background understanding, you find out his entire background, his entire history. He writes letters to the police based on cases that appear to be in the media, and therefore he offers testimony.
The judge ruled prosecutors, quote, severely violated the rules. No defendant, he said, is guaranteed a perfect trial. A defendant is guaranteed a fair trial. George, can we talk to you? Could you get State's attorney?
Yep.
Deputy State's Attorney George Hazel was in the courtroom when the new trial was ordered. He declined to stop for questions. State's Attorney Greg Bernstein declined requests to speak with the media. He issued a written statement saying he was disappointed. The new trial date in this case is set for May 28th. The charge of first-degree murder no longer applies in this case. That's because of double jeopardy. Michael Johnson was already tried and found not guilty of that count. Reporting live tonight from the Circuit Court, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.
Jane, thank you.